Isaiah. Chapter 50. Thus says Jehovah, where is the bill of your mother's divorce with which I have put her away? Or to which of my creditors have I sold you? Indeed, for your iniquities you were sold, and for your transgressions your mother was put away. Why when I came was there no man? And when I called, why was there no one to answer? Is my hand so short that it cannot redeem? Or do I have no power to deliver? Indeed, at my rebuke I dry up the sea, I make the rivers a wilderness, their fish stink because there is no water, and die of thirst. I clothe the heavens with blackness, and make sackcloth their covering. The Lord Jehovah has given me the tongue of the instructed, that I should know how to sustain the weary with a word. He awakens me morning by morning, he awakens my ear to hear as an instructed one. The Lord Jehovah has opened my ear, and I was not rebellious, nor did I turn back. I gave my back to those who strike me and my cheeks to those who pluck out the hair, I did not hide my face from humiliation and spitting. The Lord Jehovah helps me, therefore I have not been dishonored, therefore I have set my face like a flint, and I know that I will not be put to shame. The one who justifies me is near, who will contend with me? Let us stand up together. Who is my adversary in judgment? Let him come near to me. Indeed, the Lord Jehovah helps me, who is the one who condemns me? Indeed, they will all wear out like a garment, the moth will consume them. Who among you fears Jehovah, who hears the voice of his servant, who walks in darkness and has no light? Let him trust in the name of Jehovah, and rely on his God. Indeed, all of you who kindle a fire, who surround yourselves with firebrands, walk into the light of your fire and into the firebrands which you have lit. You will have this from my hand, you will lie down in torment. Isaiah. Chapter 51. Listen to me, you who pursue righteousness, who seek after Jehovah, look to the rock from which you were hewn, and to the excavation of the quarry from which you were dug. Look to Abraham your father, and to Sarah who travailed with you, for I called him when he was one person, and blessed him and multiplied him. For Jehovah has comforted Zion, he has comforted all her waste places, and made her wilderness like Eden, and her desert like the garden of Jehovah. Gladness and joy will be found in her, thanksgiving in the voice of song. Hearken to me, O my people, give ear to me, O my nation, for instruction will go out from me, and I will set my judgment as a light for the peoples. My righteousness is near, my salvation has gone forth, my arms will judge the peoples, the coastlands will wait for me and place their hope in my arm. Lift up your eyes to the heavens, and look upon the earth beneath, for the heavens will vanish away like smoke, and the earth will wear out like a garment, and those who dwell there will die in like manner, but my salvation will be forever, and my righteousness will not be abolished. Listen to me, you who know righteousness, a people in whose heart is my instruction, do not fear the reproach of man, do not be terrified at their revilings. For the moth will eat them up like a garment, and the worm will eat them like wool, but my righteousness will be forever, and my salvation from generation to generation. Awake, awake! Put on strength, O arm of Jehovah, awake as in the days of old, as in the generations of past ages. Was it not you who cut Rahab in pieces, who pierced through the dragon? Was it not you who dried up the sea, the waters of the great deep, who made the depths of the sea into a way for the redeemed to pass through? Therefore the ransomed of Jehovah will return and will come to Zion with a ringing shout, and eternal joy will be upon their heads. They will lay hold on gladness and joy, and sorrow and sighing will flee away. I, even I, am he who will comfort you. Who are you that you are afraid of man who will die, and of the Son of Man who will be made like grass? That you have forgotten Jehovah who made you, who stretched out the heavens and laid the foundations of the earth, that you have been continually afraid every day, because of the fury of the oppressor when he sets himself up to destroy you? But where is the fury of the oppressor? The one who is bowed down will soon be released and will not die in the pit, nor will his bread be lacking. I am Jehovah your God, who stirs up the sea so that its waves roar, Jehovah of hosts is his name. And I have put my words in your mouth, and I have covered you in the shadow of my hand, to plant the heavens and lay the foundations of the earth, and to say to Zion, you are my people. Wake yourself up, wake yourself up, stand up, O Jerusalem, you who have drunk from the hand of Jehovah the cup of his wrath, the bowl of the cup of staggering you have drunk, you have drained it out. There is no one to guide her among all the children whom she has brought forth, there is no one to take her by the hand among all the children she has raised up. These two things have happened to you, who will lament for you? Desolation and destruction, and famine and sword. How will I comfort you? Your sons have fainted, they lie at the head of every street like an antelope in a net, full of the wrath of Jehovah, the rebuke of your God. Therefore hear this now, O afflicted one, you who are drunk but not with wine. Thus says your Lord Jehovah and your God who pleads the cause of his people, indeed, I have taken from your hand the cup of staggering, you will no longer need to drink the bowl of the cup of my wrath anymore. And I will put it into the hand of those who afflict you, who have said to your soul, bow down that we may walk over you, and you have made your back like the ground, like the street for them to cross over. Isaiah Chapter 52. Awake! Awake! Put on your strength, O Zion, put on your beautiful garments, O Jerusalem, O holy city, for the uncircumcised and the unclean will no longer come into you. Shake yourself from the dust, arise, sit down, O Jerusalem, loose yourself from the bonds on your neck, O captive daughter of Zion. For thus says Jehovah, you are those who have been sold for nothing, and you will be redeemed without money. For thus says the Lord Jehovah, at first my people went down to Egypt to sojourn there, then the Assyrian oppressed them without cause. Now then what do I have here, declares Jehovah, since my people have been taken away for nothing? Those who rule over them howl, declares Jehovah, and my name is continually blasphemed all day long. Therefore my people will know my name, therefore in that day they will know that I am he who speaks, here I am. How beautiful on the mountains are the feet of him who brings good news, of him who announces peace, who brings news of good things, who announces salvation, of him who says to Zion, your God reigns. The voice of your watchmen. They lift up their voice, they give a ringing shout together, for they will see with their very own eyes when Jehovah restores Zion. Break forth, give a ringing shout together, you wasted places of Jerusalem, for Jehovah has comforted his people, he has redeemed Jerusalem. Jehovah has bared his holy arm in the sight of all the nations, and all the ends of the earth will see the salvation of our God. Depart. Depart. Go out from there. Do not touch any unclean thing. Go out from the midst of her. Cleanse yourselves, you who bear the vessels of Jehovah. For you will not go out in haste, and you will not go in flight, for Jehovah will go before you, and the God of Israel will be your rear guard. Indeed, my servant will act wisely and will prosper, he will be exalted and lifted up and very high. Even as many were astonished at him, his visage was marred more than that of any man, and his form more than that of the sons of men. So will he surprise many nations, kings will shut their mouths because of him, for what had not been recounted to them they will see, and what they had not heard of they will contemplate. Isaiah Chapter 53. Who has believed our report? And to whom has the arm of Jehovah been revealed? For he grew up like a tender plant before him, and like a root out of dry ground. He has no attracting form nor majesty that we should look upon him, nor beautiful appearance that we should desire him. He was despised and forsaken of men, a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief, and like one from whom men hide their faces, he was despised, and we did not esteem him. Surely he has borne our sicknesses, and carried our sorrows, yet we ourselves esteemed him stricken, smitten of God and afflicted. But he was wounded because of our transgressions, he was crushed because of our iniquities, the chastening for our peace was upon him, and by his stripes we have been healed. We all like sheep have gone astray, each of us has turned to his own way, and Jehovah has caused the iniquity of us all to fall on him. He was oppressed, and it was he who was afflicted, yet he did not open his mouth, like a lamb that is led to the slaughter and like a sheep that is dumb before its shearers, so he did not open his mouth. By oppression and by judgment he was taken away, and as for his generation, who among them had the thought that he was cut off out of the land of the living for the transgression of my people to whom the stroke was due? And they assigned his grave with the wicked, but with a rich man in his death, although he had done no violence, nor was there any deceit in his mouth. But Jehovah was pleased to crush him, to afflict him with grief. When he makes himself an offering for sin, he will see a seed, he will extend his days, and the pleasure of Jehovah will prosper in his hand. He will see the fruit of the travail of his soul, and he will be satisfied, by the knowledge of him, the righteous one, my servant, will make the many righteous, and he will bear their iniquities. Therefore I will divide to him a portion with the great, and he will divide the spoil with the strong, because he poured out his life unto death and was numbered with the transgressors, yet he alone bore the sin of many and interceded for the transgressors. Isaiah Chapter 54. Give a ringing shout, O barren one, you who have not born, break forth into joyful shouting and cry out, you who have not been in labor, for more numerous are the children of the desolate one than the children of the married woman, says Jehovah. Enlarge your tent site, let them stretch out the curtains of your habitations, spare not, lengthen your cords, and strengthen your pegs. For on the right and on the left you will break open, and your seed will possess the nations and will cause the desolate cities to be inhabited. Fear not, for you will not be put to shame, neither be humiliated, for you will not be ashamed, but you will forget the shame of your youth, and the reproach of your widowhood you will no longer remember. For your Maker is your husband, Jehovah of hosts is his name. And the Holy One of Israel is your Redeemer, he is called the God of all the earth. For Jehovah has called you, like a wife who has been forsaken and is grieved in spirit, even like a wife of one's youth when she has been rejected, says your God. For a short moment I forsook you, but with great compassion I will gather you. In a flood of wrath I hid my face from you for a moment, but with eternal loving kindness I will have mercy on you, says Jehovah your Redeemer. For this is like the waters of Noah to me, when I swore that the waters of Noah would not overflow the earth ever again, so I have sworn that I will not be angry with you, nor will I rebuke you. For the mountains may depart, and the hills may shake, but my loving kindness will not depart from you, and my covenant of peace will not shake, says Jehovah who has compassion on you. O afflicted one, storm-tossed and not comforted, indeed, I myself will lay down your stones in dark mortar, and will lay your foundations with sapphires. And I will make your battlements of rubies, and your gates of carbuncles, and all your borders will be precious stones. And all your children will be taught of Jehovah, and the peace of your children will be great. In righteousness you will be established, you will be far from oppression, for you will not fear, and far from terror, for it will not come near you. Indeed, they may fiercely attack you, but it is not of me, whoever attacks you will fall because of you. Indeed, it is I who have created the blacksmith who blows the fire of the coals, and brings out a weapon for its work, and it is I who have created the destroyer to ruin. No weapon that is formed against you will prosper, and every tongue that rises up to judge you, you will condemn. This is the heritage of the servants of Jehovah, and their righteousness which is of me, declares Jehovah.